Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem, and then as we honor our Aboriginal heritage with an honor song by Joseph Harper, who is Cree from the Bear Clan. Thank you, Joseph. Please take your seats. On behalf of George Brown College, I would like to welcome you all, graduates, family, and friends, to this afternoon's convocation exercises for the class of 2012. My name is Georgia Quartaro. I'm Acting Vice President Academic and Dean of the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies. And it is my pleasure to serve as your Master of Ceremonies this afternoon. Our convocation ceremony today is taking place on the traditional lands of the Mississaugas of New Credit. I would now like to introduce the members of our platform party. I will ask them to stand and remain standing as they are introduced. Please hold your applause until the end of the introductions. It is my particular pleasure to introduce Sally Horsfall Eaton, newly appointed as the first chancellor of George Brown College. Mm-hmm. going to hold applause. From the Board of Governors of George Brown College, Lynn Nagel. From George Brown College, Ann Sato, President of the College. Eugene Harrigan, Vice President, Corporate Services. Karen Thompson, Vice President, Marketing and Strategic Enrollment Management. Nancy Hood, Executive Director, Human Resources. Diane Tessier, Registrar. Brenda Pipitone, Dean, Academic Services and Student Affairs. Lori Schechter-Wolfson, Assistant Vice President, Waterfront Development. And Corey Ross, Acting Dean, Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Health Sciences. I would also like to acknowledge our Elder in Residence, Pauline Shirt, who is Cree from the Red-Tailed Hawk Clan, originally from Saddle Lake, Alberta. And finally, the staff and faculty, if you would please, the staff and faculty of the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies at George Brown College. Ladies and gentlemen, your platform party. Please take your seats. This afternoon, we are recognizing graduates from the School of Social and Community Services and the School of Deaf and Deafblind Studies in the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood, and graduates from the School of Work and College Preparation in the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies. Our interpreters this afternoon are Monique Ledrew, Tara Everett, and Bonnie Lynn Barker, and our captioner is Joanne Anderson. I will now call upon Lori Schechter-Wolfson, Assistant Vice President, Waterfront Development, to address the graduates on behalf of the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood. Lori?
Madam President, Madam Chancellor, members of the platform party, staff, and guests, and graduates! You never surprise me, you're so shy, all of you. On behalf of the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood, I extend my congratulations to the graduates on completing their programs of study. The programs you have been a part of and the professions you are about to enter represent an important sector in Canada, that is, engaging our communities and providing services to many who do not have a voice. Services such as American Sign Language interpreting, linking clients with social supports when they do not know where or who to turn for help, working with vulnerable communities, or helping children and youth in distress are only a few ways our graduates truly make a difference. The future rests with graduates like you, who are concerned about the social determinants of health in our diverse communities, who care about the well-being of individuals and communities around the world, and who, most importantly, understand and are prepared to work with people in need. As students, you've had many experiences here in Toronto, and in some cases in countries such as Jamaica. With our, yes, I guess some of you went to Jamaica. With our focus on collaborative practice, you have learned from each other, shared your expertise, and most importantly, discovered what it means to be part of a team. Now you can take that learning and all of your experiences and go out into the world as a proud graduate of George Brown College. And finally, I know you will join me in thanking and acknowledging the faculty and staff behind me from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies for their passion, for their work that they do every day, and their commitment to their students. Let's hear it for them. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Laurie. As Acting Vice President Academic and as Dean of the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies, I also want to congratulate all the graduates. Graduation is one of the days you had in mind when you started college, at moments when you knew you were going to be successful, and perhaps at moments when you weren't sure how or even if this was all going to work out. Many of you have had significant challenges to overcome, but you have persevered and completed your programs. Congratulations. Yeah, absolutely. Learning is lifelong. You have been learning before you were born, since before you were born, and you'll continue to learn all your lives. However, being a student is a time of special focus and preparation. It has been a chance to develop skills, to think critically, and to consider new ideas. Some of you are ready to pursue the careers for which you have prepared. Others are looking ahead to further education first. I hope that you value and have enjoyed the learning in all your studies. They all contribute to the best result of education, being able to think clearly, to feel deeply, and to act wisely. I congratulate you on what you have achieved, and I wish you success. I am delighted to introduce today's convocation speaker, Dr. George Ross, President of Central Michigan University. Central Michigan University is 120 years old and is the fourth largest university in Michigan. Dr. Ross has been president of Central Michigan University since 2010. Prior to that, he served as president of Alcorn State University, vice president for finance and administrative services at Central Michigan University, so he left and he came back, and has also held faculty and administrative positions at several other American universities. Dr. Ross began his career as a certified public accountant and held positions in corporate and nonprofit finance and management prior to his long career in higher education. He earned his bachelor's and master's degrees in business administration from Michigan State University, a PhD in higher education administration from the University of Alabama, and completed postdoctoral studies at Harvard University. As you can see, Dr. Ross's own career is an excellent example of lifelong learning. Throughout this career, Dr. Ross has been dedicated to student success and academic excellence, with a strong belief in the transformative power of education. He has had ongoing involvement with traditional and non-traditional teaching and learning. In addition to his own experience as a professor, he has developed educational materials and taught professional development courses. He continues to present lectures, seminars, and workshops on leadership in higher education. He is a strong proponent of civic engagement and giving back to his community, and has served on boards and planning councils. George Brown College is committed to lifelong learning for our students, for those of you who are graduating today, and for the college's staff. We have a long-standing relationship with Central Michigan University, which offers a graduate degree program with classes on site at George Brown College for our staff and for others seeking degrees in higher education. Some college staff who are currently in the Central Michigan University's master's program have been able to join us on the platform today, and I'd like them to stand to be acknowledged. Would you please? Thank you. Graduates, I hope that you are inspired by the commitment to lifelong learning in Dr. Ross's own career and in the people who have taught and supported you and other students. Learning never stops. Today marks a wonderful culmination of your studies. We want you to celebrate, and we want you to be proud. We also want you to go on learning through the work that you do and perhaps through other courses and credentials so that you continue to develop your knowledge and skills and to reach for new opportunities. I am very pleased that we have a speaker today who exemplifies the power of education in his own life as well as his commitment to its value for others. Dr. Ross, I invite you to come forward and address convocation.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Vice President Quartaro, for that kind introduction. Madam President and Madam Chancellor, I'm delighted for this opportunity to address the 2012 graduating class of George Brown College on this auspicious occasion. I'm delighted that each of you, family, friends, faculty, college staff, and especially our soon-to-be George Brown College alums are here to join in celebrating the graduates' tremendous achievement. Please join me in a round of applause for the graduates today. And I also want to extend a special recognition to the Central Michigan University Chippewas, who are on the platform today. While these students won't complete their coursework until later this summer, it is only appropriate that they join in this celebration and this partnership with George Brown College and CMU in our role in higher education in Ontario, which is now in its 35th year. Graduates, as we gather today to celebrate your significant achievements, let's not lose sight of the hard work, perseverance, and the desire to learn that got you to this momentous occasion. Completing your program of studies indicates that not only do you have the ability to succeed, but equally as important, it demonstrates you were motivated and committed to seeing something through to the end. Your demonstrated drive and determination, the abilities you displayed in being able to complete these demanding programs, and the knowledge, skills, and values that you've learned and developed in your studies have prepared all of you to be successful in your personal and professional lives. You've already demonstrated your passion for learning. I hope this passion to learn is something that you will carry with you for a lifetime, for knowledge has tremendous value. Think of it as you would currency, and never, never stop learning. In today's rapidly changing world, where information travels at the speed of light and new technological innovations are a daily occurrence, you must constantly assess the knowledge that you possess. You should ask yourself questions such as, are you stagnating intellectually? Are you up to speed on current trends? Are you falling behind? Are you continuing to learn and using the applied education you receive from George Brown College? Graduates never stop learning. It should be a perpetual process that spans your lifetime. Brian Tracy, life coach and author, is quoted as saying, "Anyone who stops learning is old, whether this happens to be at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps on learning not only remains young, but becomes constantly more valuable regardless of physical capacity. In addition to the benefits that you as individuals will enjoy because of your George Brown College education, society at large will also gain from your educational pursuits. As emerging leaders, you have the additional responsibility to use your vision and energy to explore and to discover. Keep an open mind to new ideas. Find ways to actively engage in public service. Tap into your potential to achieve and achieve beyond your wildest expectations and do something remarkable. And never stop learning. Be a role model to upcoming generations. on living a productive life, being successful, giving back to your family and community, and proudly sharing your story of life transformation that you experienced through your education that you've worked so hard to achieve. And trust me, every one of you graduates has a story. We all have a story. I wasn't always Dr. Ross. My story began on a cotton field in Mississippi, one of 12 children, 6 older, 5 younger. As my wife reminds me, all from the same household, I chose education. And with the help of great faculty and mentors along the way, still the only one of those 12 kids who ever got out of high school, let alone who got a college degree. And I now stand here as the president of one of the largest universities, not only in Michigan, but in the United States. And I keep on learning every day, all the time. And that's what I challenge you to do, never stop learning. Graduates, you've made tremendous strides during your years at George Brown College. You've had a strong learning experience that prepared you to make a difference in the world. You have the knowledge, drive, and experience to do something great, to be great. Our world is faced with many challenges. It will take the collective talent and knowledge of our next generation of leaders to make the world a better place in which to live, work, play, and prosper with dignity and respect for people around the world. As the late Robert Fitzgerald Kennedy once said, few will have the greatness to bend history itself, but each of us can work to change a small portion of events. And in the total of all those acts will be written the history of this generation. Be proud of the greatness you have shown as graduates of George Brown College. Stay connected to your school. Share your accomplishments, tell your stories as you play your role in improving the social, cultural, and economic well-being of the city region, the province, the great country of Canada, and communities throughout the world. And to my CMU students, fire up chips, and to the George Brown students, congratulations to all of you.
Thank you, George. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the part of today's ceremony in which we recognize outstanding scholastic achievement by our graduates. At this time, we would like to recognize the recipient of the Governor General's Academic Medal. This medal was first awarded in 1873 by the Earl of Dufferin, and has since become one of the most prestigious awards that a student in a Canadian educational institution can receive. The Collegiate Bronze Medal from the Governor General of Canada is awarded to a student in a 2 or 3 year program with the highest cumulative grade point average. This year, the recipient of the Governor General's Academic Medal is Jennifer Rodriguez Allen, from the Activation Coordinator Gerontology Program in the School of Health and Wellness in the Center for Health Sciences. Jennifer received her award at her convocation ceremony this morning. I would also like to recognize the recipient of the Board of Governors Medal. The Board of Governors Medal was established in 2007 when the first degree programs graduated from George Brown College. The medal is awarded to a full-time student in a degree program of at least 4 years' duration and is awarded for academic excellence to the student with the highest cumulative grade point average. This year, the recipient of the Board of Governors Medal is Candy McKinnon, who graduated yesterday with a Bachelor of Applied Business in Financial Services from the School of Financial Services in the Center for Business. I ask you to join me in congratulating both of those graduates. This afternoon, we are proud to honor three graduates from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies with a Dean's Award to recognize both their high academic achievement across all semesters within their center and their contributions to the college community. I would like to call on Corey Ross, Acting Dean, to come forward to present the award from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood. This year, our first recipient of a Dean's Award for the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood is Veronica Tugaleev. Veronica is... Veronica is a graduate of the Behavioral Science Technology Program in the School of Community and Social Services. Veronica, please come forward to accept your award. Our second recipient of a Dean's Award for the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood is Andrea Akros. Andrea Kraus. Andrea is a graduate of the American Sign Language English Interpreter Program in the School of Deaf and Deafblind Studies. Thank you, Corey. That's it, yeah. Okay. Would you just go off that way? We'll get you back to your seat. Go ahead. Okay. That's all right. This year's recipient of a Dean's Award for the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies is Michael Upshaw. Michael is a graduate of the pre-business program in the School of Work and College Preparation. Michael, would you please come forward to accept your award? Now it is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for this afternoon. Rui Oliveira is a graduate of the Pre-Community Services Program from the School of Work and College Preparation in the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies. Now, if you've been looking at your program, you might have noticed that your program says that Rui is a graduate of the Social Service Worker Program, and the program is a little bit ahead of where we are. Rui is graduating from the Pre-Community Services Program today, and he is entering the Social Services Worker Program in September. Rui, would you please address the graduating class of 2004?
Madam Chancellor, Madam President, members of the Platform Party, fellow graduates, George Brown faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is with great honor that I stand here today to celebrate and address the achievements of my fellow graduates. when Jacqueline Mascioni, coordinator for the Pre-Community Services Program, informed me that I had been selected to be valedictorian, I honestly didn't know how I could possibly address the accomplishments of so many individuals. I am overwhelmed to stand here today representing students in the School of Social and Community Services, the School of Deaf and Deaf-Blind Studies, and the School of Work and College Preparation. We all celebrate our graduation today. But it is the personal journey of each one of us in the pursuit of education that makes this a special and memorable day in our lives. For all of us, this graduation is the culmination of hard work. For some of you, it is a huge step towards a bigger goal. For me, this graduation is a dream come true. A dream that not so long ago, I was ready to give up, until I walked into George Brown College and realized it was still possible. This dream goes back to when I was a child. In conversations with my father, I started to understand how important education is. My father was a hardworking man who only attended school until he was 9 years old. And it was his lack of opportunity to acquire an education that drove him to work so hard so he could provide a better life for me and my siblings. Shortly after my 12th birthday, I lost my father in a car accident. At the time, I didn't realize the sacrifices that he made to provide for a family of seven. But today I know that it's because of his influence and guidance that I'm standing in front of you. Shortly after that, I dropped out of school and went to work. The dream of having an education had to wait. I realized that life wasn't always fair. My family struggled daily, like most families do. But despite the difficulties, what kept us together was the immeasurable love and support for each other, and my mother's lifetime dedication and sacrifice as a single parent raising five children. Still with the dream of having an education, I arrived in Canada in my early 20s, knowing hardly any English and with $80 in my pocket. And as many of you can attest, learning a new language as an adult can be quite challenging. Without any academic education and limited English skills, I believed that my dream of going back to school was still far away. 3 years ago, a work-related accident put me in a hospital bed for 20 days. Being a hard-working man most of my life, not being able to work made me feel depressed and lost. And it was in the middle of this life crisis that one day I walked into George Brown College. This is just my journey. Each of you has your own journey in the pursuit of education. We have all experienced those moments in life that tested our strength and made us question if the sacrifices will ever be worth it. Fellow graduates, the fact that we all stand here today means that it was worth it. The fact that we all stand here today means that we overcame many obstacles and became stronger for the challenges ahead. As students, we are always there for each other in support and endurance. But there are many people in our lives that we all should be grateful for. Personally, I would like to thank Neville, my partner of 7 years, for being my strongest support and believing in me even in my lowest moments. Also, thank you to my family and friends who gave support and encouragement along the journey. I would also like to thank George Brown College. I'll forever be grateful to everyone in the School of Work and College Preparation. The very first day I walked in to do my college upgrading, I saw myself as an adult with limited skills who had never completed high school. When I walked out that day, I was a mature student, full of hope and the realization that I indeed had many skills. Today, like all of you, I'm a proud college graduate with a better future ahead of me. Thank you to every professor and staff member for all the assistance, support, and encouragement, and for making the success of every student your biggest priority. Fellow graduates, for many of you, this graduation is an end to the college life. Some of you are going to miss daily contact with our closest peers. Some of you are even going to miss the sometimes demanding professors. This was my joke, sorry. The demands may continue as we move forward, but from this day on, we have a great future ahead of us. And if you ever have any doubts about yourself, bring your memory back to this day. Today, you proved to yourself that you know you are capable of achieving. Today, you proved to yourself that with patience, hard work, and some sacrifice, no challenge will ever intimidate you. Let this day give you the courage to speak in your own voice with the certainty that you will be heard. Let this day give you the strength to face and overcome your fears. Let this day give you the passion to pursue and realize your dreams. Let this day be one of the many lights in your journey. And from the heart of a man that as a child took his father's dream as his own, I wish you nothing less than what my parents wished for me. Fellow graduates, congratulations. We made it. Thank you, and have a great celebration.
Thank you, Rui. We have now reached the formal part of our ceremony where we award the credentials, the diplomas, and certificates, and these become official documents of the college. I invite Chancellor Sally Horsfall Eaton to come forward, and would the graduates please stand. Madam Chancellor, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates assembled here today have qualified in all respects for their credentials by successfully completing curricula offered by the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies at George Brown College. Faculty members have recommended that they be awarded their credentials in recognition of their academic accomplishments.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors of George Brown College, I do hereby confer on you your respective diplomas and certificates with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Madam Chancellor, on behalf of the graduates not present, I request that you confer their credentials in absentia.
I so do. And congratulations to all of you who are here and to those who are watching on the website and are not here but have receiving their certificates. Remember, it's your day today, and have a great one. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sarah. Okay. Please take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, during the next part of the ceremony, we will be presenting the graduates individually to Chancellor Sally Horsfall Eaton and President Anne Sado. To show our respect for each graduate, we ask that you remain in your seats until the last graduate has received her or his credential. We also ask that you withhold your applause until all the graduates from each program have been presented. For our graduates, we ask that upon receiving your credential, you return to your seats and enjoy the rest of the convocation program. Madam Chancellor, Madam President, I wish to present the graduates from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood and the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies so that you may confer their credentials. Our reader for today's ceremony is Patrick Kwok-Chun. Patrick graduated from the George Brown College's School of Performing Arts in 2009. He is the youngest member of their advisory board and is currently starring in the hit show War Horse.
Thank you. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood, School of Social and Community Services, from the Community Worker Program, Elizabeth Adefemi. With honors. Anna Aguirre de Garcia, with honors. Tesega Alemayehu, with honors. Ilham Bana. David Batiste, with honors. Annette Brown. Melissi Maria Cadmus. Loretta Doan, with honors. Latoya Dwyer. Nimat Elzini. Nicole Dawn Dibel, with honors. Jacqueline Farr, with honors. Kevin Ferry, with honors. Miriam Flores Martinez, with honors. Lillian Gassanol, with honors. Maria Gonzalez, with honors. Grace Francis Good. Benicia Gregory. Melissa Gunn. Lucia Habib. Fatia Hood. Haida Ikles, with honors. Teal Jared Jacques. Bernadette John, with honors. Buddy, go on. Genevieve Cachao. Irma Kameri. Stephen Kenny. Fong Li. Xiao Li Liang, with honors. Xianbo Liu, with honors. Victor Isaac Lopez. Emily McLeland, with honors. Malalai Malalai, with honors. Juette Ann Manderson, with honors. Gabriella Mariquin. Tasitra McKay, with honors. Artane Memetaj. Justin Menza. Warren Miller, with honors. Caitlin Mooney. Mukhtar Ahmed Nalayeh with honors. Bita Nasahi Geshlage with honors. Wayne Osawinimiki. Dorothy Paul. Maria Perez Diaz. Melissa Pokai with honors. Muhammad Rajab Khan with honors. George Rodriguez with honors. Elsa Rodriguez de la Gala with honors. Matthew Ruddock with honors. Mia Sky Sagara with honors. Wasma Sal Mohammed. Owen Oswald Savright with honors. Tuka Shahidi with honors. Natalie Shepherd with honors. Monique Simmons. Ryan Singh. With honors. Vincy Callister Smith with honors. Laura Sterk with honors. Ying Ji Sun with honors. Michelle Toner Kalmuski. Hei Ying Wang with honors. Wei Ying Wang. Owen Williams. Natalie Wood. Michael Jean Yoon. David Yunin with honors. Lixiu Yu with honors. Elizabeth Zacatelco Miranda. Lina Zolotko with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Child and Youth Worker Program. Christina Rosa Anania. Francis Atta with honors. Mark Alexander Bailey with honors. Angela Barahona. Natasha Batista. Caitlin Boyer with honors. Jamie Brassard with honors. Gina Gao with honors. Sarah Cardenas with honors. Heather Lynn Kavanaugh with honors. Jung Eun Cha. Julie Coburn with honors. Elizabeth Comas with honors. Leonie Dean. Chantal Donoso with honors. Maria Chelsea Douglas with honors. Crystal Dunbar. Tammy Fedorchuk with honors. Pearl Fernandez with honors. Sophia Georgelis. Andrew Stephen Hardy. Vanessa Hausman, with honors. Nicole Erin Hishon. Erica Holm, with honors. Rong Huang. Osiakina Igwe. Chantal Marie Inacio. Alden Jerome Isaacs. Sean Canheim, with honors. Melanie Lambert. Kirsten Lee, with honors. Alana Maria Lotto, with honors. Sheena Malto. Ivana Master, with honors. Natasha Mazzola, with honors. Natasha Liliane Midau, with honors. Ryan Christopher Nick, with honors. Helena Oded, with honors. Jessica Margaret Pancheco, with honors. Melissa Sandra Panone. Gail Sarika Persaud, with honors. Simone Peters, with honors. Sabrina. Aisha Nargis Papalzai, with honors. Samantha Powers, with honors. Liza Marie Pures, with honors. Priya Chantel Ramgulam, with honors. Laura Ribello. Melissa Elizabeth Regis, with honors. Nicole Ross, with honors. Harmanjit Saini. Stephanie Santo, with honors. Belkis Sequera, with honors. Michelle Silva. Robin Simpson. Ka Yan Phoebe So. Stefano Soma, with honors. Sarah Stanizic, with honors. Jennifer States. Diana Olivia Thompson. Leanna Trung. Nicole Wemigwans. With honors. Shabri White, with honors. Shanika Wilson. Yekaterina Zelenskaya. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Career and Work Counselor Program. Ivy Sophia Abaca, with honors. Jose Acevedo, with honors. Michelle Adams, with honors. Floyd Anderson, with honors. Karen A. Aponte, with honors. Fernando Belza, with honors. Christine Bowden, with honors. Abdurrahim Braksa with honors. Lesma Chang with honors. Imelda Christian with honors. Paulette De La Cruz with honors. Carolyn Doris with honors. Mercilyn Durant with honors. Farah Fake with honors. Renata Fusa Lima with honors. Monica Ganguly with honors. Simone Yvette Gomes with honors. Samantha Gomez with honors. Lubika Halimova with honors. Mona Hashim with honors. Valbona Hiseni. Laniel Jacques with honors. Jonah Lynn Elizabeth Jones with honors. Yuko Kitabake with honors. Margaret Ebifega. Miao Dan Quang with honors. Xiaoqiu Quang with honors. Lyudmila Kukta with honors. Thomas Quan with honors. Christine Labuka with honors. Lydia Lachlan with honors. Na Anita Liu with honors. Stephanie Lowe with honors. Diane Joan Mary McLeland with honors. Asma Sultana Muktadir with honors. Annabelle Jane Murray with honors. Nola Myrie. Shanaz Namdar with honors. Nadia Fid with honors. Suzanne Maureen Pritzker with honors. Becky Rampersad with honors. Marta Maria Rondini with honors. Teresita Rosalyn with honors. Sabir Sami with honors. Cassie Seward with honors. Andrew Shaver with honors. Mark Stephen Simon with honors. Kim Tran with honors. Lorna Campbell with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Behavioral Science Technology Program. John Brian Curtinhas, with honors. Jacqueline Christine D'Alessandro, with honors. Crystal Hamre Lowe. Zara Reed. Tracy Corenteng. Julie Lin, with honors. Chantal McDonald Stoven. Rachel McMahon. Miyuki Mogi-Stern with honors. Kadeen Moore. Chelsea Namiache. Michelle Reiterer. Angela Starr. Veronica Tugaleva with honors. Ashley Woodard. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Social Service Worker Program. Damilar Bashiru Abdul Malik Bala. Andrew Robert Graham Adams. Jennifer Anderson, with honors. Catherine Ankra, with honors. Tagart Georgia Lee Archer, with honors. Sung Gong Bei, with honors. Melanie Baker, with honors. Ratika Parmar Baksh, with honors. Nora Lynn Balthazar, with honors. Sandra Lee Barnes Funatin. Sophia A. Barrett. Stephanie Beausoleil, with honors. Ashley Bewley. Aliyah Binyamin, with honors. Selena Nabella Binyamin. Jennifer Bober, with honors. Benafshe Brenda Bojnordi. Donald Bolter, with honors. Moya Box. Hyacinth Bryan, with honors. Charlene Ann Burden. Chelsea Carrington Sallow. Soon Young Che, with honors. Constance Chakawata, with honors. David Wayne Trachalis, with honors. Christina Christian, with honors. Amanda Clark, with honors. Jane Catherine Mary Cole, with honors. Damian Daniel Delaney. Sarah Michelle Dereski, with honors. Daniel DeSantos. Stephanie Mary Shirley Doucet. Sharon Marie Doughty Cruz. Stacy John Duffy, with honors. Andrew Benson Ennis, with honors. Alicia Celeste Esser. Neville Evans Jr. Aisha Farouk. Salma Furtis, with honors. Tracy Lane Ferguson, with honors. Finnegan Rayan. Donald Walter Ford, with honors. April Lee Gazzaloni, with honors. Sharon Gorman. Anna Granovalsky, with honors. Melanie Guittard. Caitlin Harkins, with honors. Chantel Harakasoon, with honors. Brian Harris, with honors.
Fight the real enemy!
Bianca Tosha Henry. Selena Henry. Jennifer Herbert, with honors. Rebecca Emily Solomon Herz. Michaela Huang, with honors. Michelle Ilios. Jeremy Jabber, with honors. Latoya Ann Marie Jackson, with honors. Quintaya Sophia Jackson. Luo Ying Jin. Lindsay Johnson, with honors. Karthia Kanagasabai, with honors. Carl James Matthew Kanagizer, with honors. Hedaye Karimian, with honors. Sadia Khan, with honors. Mohan Prasad Kwarel, with honors. Yongmin Michael Kim, with honors. Yoon Hee Kim. Sunganja Krishnamurti, with honors. Sharon Andrea Krong, with honors. Stephanie Kuchma, with honors. Gregory Lane, with honors. Kyu-Tsi Hai Lee. Diana Legisimo. With honors. Diane Loretta LaRue, with honors. Janelle Lewis, with honors. Eva McNeil. Nyembesi Mavhondo, with honors. Joan Marembe. Natasha Mohammed. Maria Montero, with honors. Daria Musiu, with honors. Christine Newson, with honors. Ayan Omar. Alicia Renee Palmer. Poneet Kaur Panu, with honors. Rukaya Parveen, with honors. Nabila Parvez. Elvia Maria Panat, with honors. Jovanka Perovic, with honors. Francis Pinedia, with honors. Carol Plummer. Prima Raju, with honors. Gerard Ribeiro, with honors. Jennifer Rennie, with honors. Jessica Retz, with honors. Jennifer Louise Rosser, with honors. Maria Santa Cruz, with honors. Kelly Marshall. Emily Larson. Mami Awa Nguer, with honors. Norma Rivera, with honors. Eduardo Ordonez, with honors. Zabula Nouri. Felicia Smith Roberts. Victoria Martins. Christine Susan Tropia. Padmini Patazar, with honors. Nicole Perrone, with honors. Samine Riazzi, with honors. Luisa Rodriguez, with honors. Pinky Paglingayan. Lydia Santisteban. Ria Reshma Singh, with honors. Darsha Savandaraj, with honors. Deborah St. Louis. Christina Maria Staley, with honors. Evernice Tapfumanaye. Anna Cherepova, with honors. Gayatri Teyagamurti, with honors. Margot Todd Hunter, with honors. Christina Tolles, with honors. Allison Ann Townsley, with honors. Amanda Elizabeth Joyce Tufts. Francine Umuhoza. Laura Rosemary Vickers, with honors. Lee Williams, with honors. Janelle Wilson. Leticia Michelle Angelica Wilson. Jennifer Winters, with honors. Jerusalem Juarez. Jianping Zhang, with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Autism and Behavioral Science Program. Orico Ann, with honors. Corey Tamika Anderson Mercurius. Amelia Chandra. Tina Karen Chandran. Cherise Chin, with honors. Scott Connors, with honors. Allison Doris. Kelly Elaine Fitzgerald, with honors. Richa Grover, with honors. Naima Katoon. Christy Love. Blanche Louis, with honors. Danielle Marie McLean, with honors. Shauna Lee O'Connor. Marianthi Papatheodorou, with honors. Daliborka Markov, with honors. Melissa Maria Setikaze, with honors. Melissa Snow, with honors. Zachary Thomas Such, with honors. Elemedi Thanabalasingam, with honors. Rochelle Wine, with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Community Services and Early Childhood, School of Deaf and Deafblind Studies, the Intervener for Deafblind Persons Program. Colette Ann Backus. Rebecca Amy Blundell, with honors. Anne Breen, with honors. Krista Elizabeth Clark. Kayla Cusack. Crystal Dunlop. Leanne Fester. Jimmy George. Caitlin Dawn Graham. Laura Stephanie Martire, with honors. Denise Matos. Catherine Matoro. Gwyn Moore. Emily Ann Shin. Julie Diane Sproul. Katie Ann Stuckless. Margarita Texiera. Amanda Temolder. Roger Eric Troche. Justine May Veneration. Kirsty Wyment, with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the American Sign Language English Interpreter Program. William Beck, with honors. Ilana Shoshana Fields. Corrine Beth Grappuzzo, with honors. Mary Immel. Ryan Lorne Kraft, with honors. Andrea Krause, with honors. Alexandria Skrisniak. Jordan Lee Thompson. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the American Sign Language and Deaf Studies Program. Christine J. Broadfoot, with honors. Clarence Cancicio. Christina G, with honors. Christina Hall, with honors. D. Meehan. Kanal Parikh. Andrea Marie Pearson, with honors. Nadia Amelia Rajab, with honors. Brianne Richards, with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Center for Preparatory and Liberal Studies, School of Work and College Preparation, the College Vocational Program, Victor Aina, Jennifer Austin, Winter Davies, Kyle Brandon Ford Chataway, with honors. Catherine Garcia, with honors. Leonardo Alejandro Guerra, with honors. Hope Hackner, with honors. Jeffrey Joseph Hamilton, with honors. Mashoud Ahmed Khan. Shanice McLean, with honors. Melanie Medeiros. Veronica Morales, with honors. Michael Jr. Moskin. Dennis Mark Orpiano, with honors. Jason Park. Ben Quinton. Elizabeth Rabko. Ron Rolada, with honors. Michael Seamus, with honors. Eric Steele. Stuart Thompson, with honors. Richard Venegas. Justin Azuka Vivero. Jack Sullivan Westgate. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Pre-Health Science Program. Almira Almonte. Harima Amin. Simarpreet Kaur, with honors. Brittany Ragunanan. Hamda Rashid, with honors. Ryan Matthew Scambia, with honors. Pushpa Sharma. Manari Subasingh. Virginia Waite. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Pre-Community Services Program. Tobias Bashe. Mei Cheng. Robert DePriest, with honors. Sarah Elizabeth Merlos, with honors. Alberto Munoz, with honors. Bucky Odubona. Rui Oliveira, with honors. Michelle Renee Robin Roth, with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the pre-business program. Frederick Ventayan Bataclan. Brittany Andrade. Romy Chakraborty. Jordan Cohen. Masego Dubay. Cameron Robert McDonald. Caitlin Tess McDougall with honors. Sarup Pahal. Adrian Myron Rotko. Nicholas Giovanni Skelska. Curtis Lee Stewart with honors. Michael Upshaw with honors. Sophia Elizabeth White with honors. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Hospitality Services Program. Lauren Tanya Hine. Samantha Hiscock, with honors. Brittany Mae Clavette. Vanessa Mitzi, with honors. Giuseppe Gianfranco Moretti. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Assistant Cook Program. Nicole Adibanjo. Charlene Chambers. Yasmin Anwar. Rochelle DeRoche. Fatima Nuha Hameen. Daniel Higgs. Wendell Joseph. Kevin Micah. Rhonda Ross. Karen Wright. Jonas Todd Zweggers. Thank you, Madam Chancellor. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you the 2012 graduates for their credentials from the Construction Craft Worker Foundations Program. Parithapan Selvakumar with honors. And from the Community Worker Program, Alisa Carrera Austin. Thank you, Madam Chancellor, and congratulations, all graduates.
of... Nope. Mic's not on. There, it's still there. It's good. Try again. This concludes the granting of our credentials. I now invite President Ansedo to address the graduates of the class of 2012.
Madam Chancellor, distinguished guests, students and faculty, parents and friends, good afternoon to this convocation, which has been the most effusive and celebratory yet. To the class of 2012, while I've congratulated you all individually, I want to again collectively say congratulations. You've reached the finish line of your education at George Brown, and now it's time for your victory lap. Be sure to soak in all the applause, and there's been plentiful this afternoon, but it's very, very well deserved. Convocation is my favorite time of the year because it fills me with such pride in you, our students. Before me today, I see innovators and problem solvers, future leaders and lifelong learners. I see an auditorium full of skilled graduates about to embark on rewarding new careers, well equipped with the knowledge and training they obtained at George Brown College. There's clearly electricity in the air. For some of our graduates, this convocation marks the start of a first career. For many others, it's the second or third, and I know many of you will be going on to further studies. It's been said that change is the only constant in life, and that feels particularly true today. As technology evolves at lightning speed and social demands change alongside it, we're seeing entire industries reinvented. Innovation expert Jim Carroll predicts that 65% of the children in preschool today will work in jobs that don't even currently exist. So, if you feel like the ground is shifting underneath your feet, you're not imagining things. But I have good news for you. You've already started to build expertise in adapting to change. You've been building those skills during your entire academic career at George Brown, exploring new fields of study while juggling competing deadlines, heavy course loads, and family responsibilities. I'm well aware of the challenges faced by students today, but this convocation is a testament to your resilience in the face of those pressures. The college has been changing around you as well. One of our college's greatest strengths is our willingness to acknowledge and embrace change in order to offer the most up-to-date training possible. We want our graduates to leave the college armed with the critical skills, knowledge and capabilities that employers value most, and the ability to embrace change so that you're ready for anything. Over the past few years, during your time at the college, we've undertaken a number of game-changing activities. These include integrating a communications component into the curriculum of programs across the college. Communication skills have been identified by employers as a key ingredient for success in the workplace. New or upgraded simulated learning environments, such as the ASL lab and our early childhood lab school.